let's learn about files. In this video, we will implement three functions: GetFileSize, ReadEntireFileBinary, and WriteEntireFileBinary. You'll also learn some low-level insights, so let's start. Now, you might be wondering, why do I write an entire file? Well, this pattern happens to be useful in game development. It is very efficient, simple, and less error-prone. You can, for example, take a struct that is relevant to the game and write it entirely and later read it back to basically save and load the game state. I have a library that is based on that, and I link a video on it here when it will be released. Let's start with the simplest function: GetFileSize. First, we need to get a file handle. If you remember from day 2, a handle is just a Windows object and it refers to a file in this case, but it can refer to other things like a console buffer. First, we specify the file name. Then, we specify that you want to read from the file. Then we get to this weird parameter called share mode. You see, file operations are atomic. So one process can write into a file, and the other one will have to wait until it can also write into it. If you do multiple operations, however, the two processes will fight over the file. You don't usually want that. So whenever you get a handle to a file, you can specify that you don't want other people to mess with it. In our case, we can specify file share read, meaning that others can read from our file, but not modify it, until we are done. And by done, that means closing the handle. The next parameter can be ignored. Then we specify that you want to open an existing file, and the last two parameters are again not interesting. Now we just have to check if the handle was valid. If not, some errors occurred, and if you want more details, just call getLastError and look at the documentation for the possible cases. Finally, we can call getFileSizeEx, and if it doesn't fail, we can return the size. Don't forget to close the handle. As a quick note, closing the process will automatically close all the handles that you created. Now let's implement reading and writing to a file. We are going to assume that the file can always be modified by outside. Because it can, so you should take care of that possibility. So getting the file size, then allocating a buffer of that size, and then resizing the entire file into a buffer is not a safe operation, because the file size could have been increased in the meantime. So this version of the function will allocate the memory for you and make sure it won't allow anyone to change the file until it finishes filling the buffer. I'll take a vector of bytes as a memory buffer. Now we can't reuse the function from above, because we want the handle to remain open. Remember, since we specify file share read, no one can modify our file until we release the handle. So after we get the file size, we can finally call readFile. We pass the handle and the buffer, then the buffer size, a pointer to a variable where the number of bytes read will be stored, and the last parameter can be ignored. Now we check if it didn't fail, and we can also check if all the bytes were read. Don't forget to close the handle. Now let's implement WriteEntireFile. The process is similar, but we have to pass the createAlways flag when opening the file. This means that the function will open or create a new file if needed. There is also the option createNew that will create a new file or fail if it already exists. Interesting. Next we check if the size is not zero and we call WriteFile, checking if you wrote all the bytes and don't forget to close the handle. Now it's time to talk about your homework. Your fourth homework is to implement an API to allow the user to safely size his own buffer and read an entire file. You could, for example, make a struct and once you call the open method, the handle is created and the access is locked, so an operation like this is safe. You can also add a size to the readEntireFile function, and if the function does not read exactly the number of bytes specified, it fails. Your second homework is to take what you have learned in the last lesson and combine it with this one. So basically open a file dialog, open a file, and do something interesting with it. Alright, we are getting close to more interesting stuff like the window opening lesson. If you start to find the things here difficult, a trick to help you is to have an accountability partner. So basically, take a happy friend and slap him with this tutorial series, so now you both have to learn it together. I think it is a win-win situation because we will both motivate each other to learn it, and I'll get more views, so share this to a friend who is happy and you want to make his life more difficult. In the next tutorial, we'll learn about memory mapping. So, see you there!